The next major upgrade came with Android 4.4 KitKat, which introduced the Scenes and Transitions API. To see what's going on behind the scenes, let's look at a small example. When I tap this button, the OS executes a transition and needs to do a couple of things. First, it needs to capture the starting and end state for every view in the scene, and create an animator that will interpolate between the starting and end states. So in this case, the end state is that the image is gone. The starting state is that the image is visible. So here's the code to slide a view off the top of the screen. Begin delay transition takes a view group and a transition type. In this case, it's the root view and the slide transition. Immediately after the call to begin delay transition, transition manager calls capture start states, which, as the name indicates, captures the start states for all the views in the view group before we've modified them. After that's done, we modify the elements we want to change or transition. When the frame is done, transition manager calls capture end states, which does, you guessed it, stores the end states of all of the views in the view groups. The transition calls create animator with these states creates an animator set and executes it. The SDK comes with a bunch of prefabricated transitions listed here. Be mindful that all of them aren't supported on all versions of Android. So if you require them, you might be excluding some users.